Monk's topology, chapter 2. We're going to start section 12. And our objective is to define topological spaces. Let's begin by writing a definition. We start by having a set like X. Let X be a set. What is a set? A set is a collection of elements. A set like X is a collection of elements. So when you have a set, we can define subsets for that set. This is set X. It has many subsets. The collection of subsets of set X is called a topology on X if it satisfies the following conditions. So a topology on X, which is denoted by tau, is a collection of subsets of X such that, first of all, X itself and empty set, both of them are members of tau. Empty set belongs to tau, and also X belongs to tau. Two, tau, or the collection of subsets of X, is closed under union. Tau is closed under union. What's the meaning of that? It means that if we take random elements, random members from tau, and we take their union, that union belongs to tau as well. If we take members of set tau, their union is also a member of tau. And three, tau is closed under finite intersection. Tau is closed under finite intersection. It means that if we take only finite numbers of members, then their intersection is also a member of tau. In this case, we say that tau is a topology on set X. And we say that X along with tau forms a topological space. X and tau is called topological space. Well, elements of this topological space are called open sets. Note that the members. So are called open sets. Let us go over one example. Example one, and I'm going to combine example one and example two together. Suppose we have a set like X with only three members, A, B, and C. We call that if the cardinality of a set like X is equal to N, then we have 2 to the n subsets of sets X. In this case, we have a set including A, B, C. The cardinality of set X is equal to 3, so we have 2 to the third or 8 subsets. What are those subsets? The first one is empty set, the second one is set X, subsets including just one member, A, B, and C, subsets including two members. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 subsets. So now we're going to take these subsets and form topology on X. To form topology on X, we take these subsets, the ones that actually satisfy those three conditions are formed a topological space for us. Then we check three conditions. The first set of subsets that I'm going to work with are empty set and X itself. So let toe be a set including just empty set and X. Is this a topology on X? Well, we have to check three conditions. The first condition says, hey, empty set and X must be in toe. As you can see, these two are members of set toe. So the first condition is met. The second condition says toe needs to be closed under union, arbitrary union. Under union. Well, this set just includes two members. The union of X and empty set is just X, which is in toe. So the second condition is also met. The third condition, toe, is closed under finite intersection. We only have two members for this collection, empty set and set X. The intersection X and empty set is equal to empty set, which actually is a member of toe. So the third condition is also met. It means that we have a topological space since all of these conditions, properties are met. It means that X along with 2, which is empty set, and X is a topological space. So in general, if we have a set like X along with the topology on X, which is X, an empty set, this topological space is called the trivial topological space. Trivial topological space. Well, now we're going to construct another topology on X. So for the same set, set X including ABC, I'm going to define top to be power set of X, which is the set including all subsets of X. Empty set, X, A, B, C, A, B, A, C, and B, C. Question is this a topology on X? To answer this question, we need to check three conditions. The first one says, okay, empty set must be in 2, and also X must be a member of 2. As you can see, empty set and X, both of them belong to 2. The first condition is met. How about the second condition? The second condition is also met. So is closed under union of its members. You can take any collection of these sets in tow and find the union. The union of any of them, any pair of them, or you can take 3 of them, 4 of them, it's going to be a member of 2 again. So for example, empty set union with C, is C, which is in 2. You can take the union of C and AB, which is ABC, which is again in 2, and just continue taking random sets and form the union. It's going to be a member of 2. So 2 is closed under arbitrary union. And 3, 2 is closed under finite intersection. The same as 2, you can just randomly select these sets and find the intersection between them. For example, A and B and B and C. So the intersection between these two is going to be A, and here you have X. Belongs to 2. You can take, for example, A, B, C, intersection with B, intersection with C, intersection with A and C. So the intersection between A and B is empty. The intersection between A and C is going to be empty. The intersection between A and C is going to be A. The intersection between C and AIC. So you can just continue working on intersection between this set, and it's going to be you can continue this process taking the intersection. And you can actually see all of them are members of toe. So in this case, you can say that X and toe, which in this case is a power set of X, is a topological space. And we call it a discrete topological space. It is called a discrete topological space. Example 3. Let X be a set. We're going to define a new topology on X. Let toe of F be defined as a subset, a collection of subsets of X such that X minus U, or the complement of U in X, is either finite or all of X. Question is toe of F. Let's go over example 3. Suppose X is a set. We define toe of F to be the collection of all subsets of X, like U, such that the complement of U in X is either finite or it's equal to X. Question is toe of F a topology on X? To check to see if toe of F is a topology on X, we have to check 3 conditions. The first condition says empty set is in toe, and also F toe of F includes X. The second condition says it's closed under arbitrary union. And the third condition says toe of F is closed under finite intersection. Let us check each of them. To show that empty set belongs to this set, we know that empty set is a subset of X. Is it satisfying the first or second one? Well, X minus empty set is X equals to X. We're not sure if X is finite or not, so we have to ignore this, but we move on to the second part, which says it's equal to all of X. So empty set is a member of toe of F. How about X itself? Is X a member of toe of F? We know that X is a subset of X. X minus X is equal to empty set. Empty set is a finite set. So X is also a member of toe of F. Second condition, we need to show that toe of F is closed under union. To prove this, we're going to take a collection of subsets of toe of F. Let U alpha be a collection of subsets of x, and at the same time, u alpha, each u alpha is a member of 12. You need to show that the union, arbitrary union of u alphas is also in 12F. To show that the union of these sets is a member of 12F, you need to show that x minus the union is either finite or it's equal to all of x. Union of u alphas is finite or it's equal to x. Well, we know that x minus union of u alphas is intersection of x minus u alphas. X minus u alpha. Here you have two cases. Know that u alphas, they are member of this collection pro sub f. It means that if you form x minus u alpha, it's either finite or it's equal to x. X minus u alpha is finite, or x minus u alpha is equal to x. If x minus u alpha is finite, the intersection of finite sets is finite. So as their intersection. So left-hand side is finite, right-hand side is finite. It means that we're done with x minus the union of u alphas. Tau alpha is closed under the union. If x minus u alpha is equal to x, the intersection of x values is also equal to x. Then their intersection is x as well. So if right hand side is equal to x, left hand side is equal to x as well. So we're done with tau f to be closed under the union. Now we need to show that this collection is closed under finite intersection. To prove this, let us take a collection of ui's. I starts from 1 and stop at n. It means that we have finite numbers of ui's, u1 to un. Now we need to show that their intersection is a member of torus. Belongs to Torf. Well, to show this, we need to form the subtraction or difference between these sets. X minus intersection of ui's, I starts from 1 and stops at n. This is equivalent to saying that this is the union of x minus ui's. And instead of analyzing left-hand side, we're going to analyze the right-hand side. So x minus ui. Know that we took ui's from this collection. So ui's, they all satisfy either the condition that the difference between x minus ui is either finite or is equal to x. So we have two cases. X minus ui is finite, or x minus ui is equal to x. If x minus ui is finite, the union the finite union of finite sets is finite. So the finite union of finite sets is finite. It means that right hand side is finite, so as left hand side. X minus the intersection of UIs is a finite set. Okay, what if X minus UI is equal to X? If X minus UI is equal to X, it means that the union of X minus UIs is the union of X, which is X. Right hand side is equal to X, so as the left hand side. So the second condition is met. You either have the first or the second. It means that 2F is closed under finite intersection. Since these three conditions are met, we say that 2F is a topology on X, or X and 2F is a topological space. Topological space, and we call it finite complement. Call it a finite complement.